all-natural rejuvenating herbal formula enhancing sexual drive, performance, and stamina. Libido Links.
You're not your mind, you're not your emotions, you're not your car, you're not your house, because then you're in fear of losing. As long as you operate out of mind, okay, this is mine, you are mine, and I own you by remembering who you are and who you're not. You could make those strong roots by establishing a good relationship with yourself. Of course, we are always seeking outside ourselves to bring happiness. You are not ready to enter any relationship until you have a very good relationship with yourself, because you're seeking things from without and not from within. If you keep asking who you are,
right,
and also keep remembering who you are not.
Okay.
In other words,
yes, give me an example.
You're not your name.
Right, okay.
You're not your body.
Right.
You're not your mind. You're not your emotions. You're not your car. You're not your house. You're not your job. Because once you just make yourself kind of a part of that, or you identify yourself with your house.
Right.
You identify yourself with your job.
Becomes
your,
an attachment.
With your career. Exactly.
Right.
And these are all mind games. And the mind is always about me and mine and I and, you know,
your ego.
My ego and my belonging, my wife, my husband, my child, it's all ownership.
Right.
And when there is ownership, then there is fear, because then you're in fear of losing. So that's one of the number one deep causes of relationships of all kinds not working, because we operate out of ego and mind.
And, interesting. Yeah,
as long as you operate out of mind, okay, this is mine, you are mine, and I own you, and you know, and you belong to me.
Right.
So I need to fix you. This is like, you know, these are the major parts that, you know, they could damage the relationships, that I have to change you.
Oh, yes.
I want to change you, yeah, because you're mine and you need to be and think and do the way I think and am.
A lot of ladies have that problem with their men in their relationships.
Right.
They want to change them.
Yes. And, you know, I think that those are the major points in a relationship that could cause, you know, a lot of deterioration.
So it's when somebody becomes possessive then of something or someone.
Yes. Then, you know, when you become possessive, then, as I said, you become attached.
So how do you detach?
By remembering who you are and who you're not.
Because of course, you know, if you're married and you have a spouse or, you know, good friends and what, we all have relationships. And how do you detach but still being attached? Do you know what I mean?
Yes. The analogy I usually use for this is be like a tree, like a big, nice oak tree that has roots down, you know, in earth and in the soil and everything, very powerful and very strong, without leaning on anything.
Oh.
And then the other tree is there, and then, you know, the branches could communicate and interact with each other, but neither one of them could, you know, either destroy or change or affect the other one. But at the same time, you're interacting and you're having a good relationship.
Mm-hmm.
As long as you have foundation, as long as you have a base, as long as you have strong roots, and those are, you know, you could make those strong roots by establishing a good relationship with yourself.
With yourself.
Yeah.
And I think I'm speaking for the ladies here, that a lot of women, we search for a man to be that for us. We are chameleons. We change with the man that we're in the relationship with. And that's why they always say to know yourself first and know who you are,
right,
what you like to do, and then find somebody that meshes with you.
Right. We are always seeking outside ourselves to bring happiness, to bring contentment, to bring peace, even love and all that. I believe that all of these are within ourselves. So you are not ready to enter any relationship until you have a very good relationship with yourself.
Right.
And once you have a good relationship with yourself, then you are ready to establish a relationship with someone else. Not because your happiness is going to be depending on that.
Right.
Not because your peace of mind is going to be depending on that. Like, in other words, you're miserable until you find someone who completes you.
Right.
Who, you know, all this, because you're seeking things from without and not from within. Mm-hmm. But once you realize who you really are, that you're not your mind. The mind, remember, is always operates out of ego, out of me and mine. And mind usually, the ego is always fearful. That's why he wants to possess,
right,
or wants to belong. You know, if you operate out of the spiritual point of view, you don't want to possess. You don't want to change. You don't want to belong. You don't become attached.